Hello, everyone. Hey, Sal, couldn't be here today. I'm Joshua Alphonse, developer advocate at ByteDance. So today is going to be a pre-recorded talk from Hey, Sal. It's on improving GPU utilization and accelerating model training with scheduling framework of NRI. Hey, Sal is a senior engineer at ByteDance, and he's working closely with the CubeWharf organization with projects like Catalyst and CubeBrain as well. So without further ado, I'll play the video. And if you have any questions at the end of the video, feel free to ask. And we can also relay these questions to Hey Sal. You can also join us on Discord and on GitHub as well. So thank you. You need audio for the... Yeah. Oh, wait.
Hello, everyone. My name is Hu Cao. Today, I am going to share a topic titled Improving GPU Utilization and Accelerating Model Training with Scheduling Framework and NRI. I am a senior software engineer at ByteDance and also a maintainer of the Catalyst project. First, I will provide some background on cognitive AI and give an overall introduction to the Catalyst project. Next, I will delve into ByteDance's practical experience in efficiently managing a large number of GPU resources based on Catalyst, including GPU sharing scheduling, topology-aware scheduling, and tidal co-location. Afterward, I will discuss the practical outcomes of these features. Finally, I will discuss the future roadmap of Catalyst in cognitive AI domain and introduce the Catalyst community. From the picture on the upper right, we can see the overall development process of cognitive with the thriving growth of the cognitive ecosystem. Kubernetes has not only found extensive applications in microservice scenarios, but also increasingly support various types of workloads, including storage services, search, ads, and recommendation services, as well as machine learning and big data jobs. With the release of ChatGPT at the end of last year, AI large models have brought about some new opportunities. On one hand, large models have significantly improved productivity across various industries, bringing new growth opportunities for businesses. On the other hand, the training and the inference of large models require large-scale resources, which has also accelerated the development of cognitive infrastructure. In addition to the opportunities brought by large models, we also encounter some challenges in the field of cognitive AI. Let's start by discussing the challenges encountered in AI inference scenarios. Due to the fact that an NVIDIA GPU can only run a single CUDA context at a time, typically, one GPU can only be allocated to a single process. As shown in the picture on the upper right, in inference scenarios, a process typically doesn't fully utilize a GPU, resulting in significant waste of resources. Therefore, in AI inference scenarios, a key objective is to improve GPU utilization through fine-grained resource management. Next, let's discuss the challenges in AI training scenarios as illustrated in this table. Different models have diverse computing and network resource requirements for their training jobs. Large models like GPT-3 require over 1,000 A100 GPUs for training for a month or more. Therefore, in AI training scenarios, another crucial objective is to accelerate model training through fine-grained resource management. To achieve the objectives mentioned above, we have incubated a resource management system called Catalyst. The name Catalyst is derived from the word catalyst in chemical reactions, and the K symbolizes its ability to provide enhanced automation for resource management for all workloads running within the Kubernetes ecosystem. It has four layers: the API layer, the master layer, the node layer, and the kernel layer. In the second part, I will present the ByteDance practices in improving AI resource efficiency based on Catalyst. Let's start with GPU sharing scheduling. First, let me analyze the limitations of the device plugin mechanism. From this diagram, you can see that vanilla Kubernetes only supports full GPU requests, which causes huge GPU waste in AI inference scenarios. And also, the device plugin interfaces lack certain important parameters, such as the metadata of the pod and the container. As shown in the picture, in the allocate interface, the only parameter is the device list. While the industry has seen various GPU virtualization solutions such as time slicing, MBS, MIG, and CUDA level hijacking, they all have some issues when it comes to the isolation of GPU memory and computing power. For isolation, flexibility, and intrusiveness. Hence, we have opted for a kernel-level virtualization solution called MGPU to implement GPU sharing scheduling. Our new GPU sharing scheduling solution enables scheduling at a granularity of one person for computing power and 1 megabyte for GPU memory. At Kubernetes level, it consists of two components, the scheduler and the device plugin. The scheduler is responsible for scheduling a pod to a suitable node and scheduling each container to suitable GPU combinations. And the device plugin is responsible for advertising MGPU resources and injecting corresponding environment variables into a container based on the scheduler's allocation results. For Kubernetes, computing power and GPU memory are treated as two separate extended resources. If GPU level scheduling is performed by Kubernetes, it may lead to a container being allocated computing power and GPU memory onto separate GPU cards, which is actually abnormal. Therefore, we have implemented a two-level scheduling involving both node and GPU through a scheduler plugin. Here is the architecture of the scheduler plugin. We have implemented several extension points, such as the pre-filter, the filter, the reserve, the pre-bind point, and the unreserved extension point. We also introduced an extended cache to store the state of the GPU cards. As for the scheduling strategy, we have implemented a two-level bin packing scheduling strategy for node and GPU. The strategy helps reduce fragmentation to improve GPU allocation and utilization rates. We have also implemented a two-level spread scheduling strategy for node and GPU, which can enhance the isolation for node and GPU failures. As for the scheduling algorithm, we abstract the entire scheduling process as an optimization problem. We choose the variance as the objective function to reflect the degree of bin packing or spread. In addition, we use the DFS algorithm to search for feasible GPU combinations and identify the optimal one. As for the node resource management, as mentioned earlier, the device plugin interfaces like certain important parameters, such as the metadata of the pod and the container. So the device plugin isn't aware of which pod and container it is processing. So we have the device plugin utilize the pod resources API of Kubernetes to locate the pod and the container, and then use a container runtime hook to inject the environment variable NVIDIA visible devices, which is used by the NVIDIA content runtime hook. The second scenario is topology-aware scheduling. First, let me analyze the limitations of Kubernetes native topology management. For one thing, the Kubernetes scheduler is not aware of the macro topology on nodes, which can lead to a high number of unexpected automation failures. For another thing, as shown in the picture, the topology manager, the topology affinity strategy only takes into account NUMA topology, which cannot meet the performance requirements of distributed model training jobs. To address the first issue, we have implemented topology-aware scheduling, which includes pluggable node resource allocation strategies, which is implemented by the QoS resource manager and the QoS resource plugins. And we also extend a scheduler plugin to filter and score nodes based on the macro topology. In addition, we have also implemented some new topology affinity policies. In distributed training scenarios, RDMA devices are used to accelerate network communications. So if a GPU and an RDMA are allocated under the same PCIe root complex, GPU-Direct RDMA can be used to accelerate communication, as shown in the picture. And the lower the hierarchy of the PCIe switch shared by a GPU and an RDMA, the greater the bandwidth. So we have customized a strategy for GPU and RDMA affinity at the PCIe switch level. Furthermore, the RDMA devices are connected to different level switches. The closer the switches connecting RDMA devices are, the greater the bandwidth for communication between ports. Therefore, we prefer to allocate RDMA devices on the same S0 switch for ports within a job, and then the same S1 switch, and then the same S2 switch. For training jobs using the PS Worker framework, parameter servers require high performance and cannot have resources allocated across NUMA nodes. In contrast, workloads usually consume a significant amount of memory bandwidth, so we have implemented an inter-pod anti-affinity policy at the NUMA level, so that parameter servers and workloads will be allocated to different NUMA nodes to avoid interference. The third scenario is tidal co-location. It arose from the challenges we encountered during capacity planning. As shown in this image, the resource utilization of online inference services exhibits a tidal pattern with very low utilization during the night, which leads to a huge waste of GPU resources. Because online inference services and offline training jobs have complex business models and homogeneous resource usage patterns, we choose to enhance daily GPU utilization through tidal co-location, also known as time sharing reuse. The tidal co-location solution consists of two parts: instance management and node pool management. The HPA controller or the training operator will scale up online services and scale down offline jobs during the daytime, while scale down online services and scale up offline jobs during the nighttime. Meanwhile, the tidal controller will adjust the nodes for online services usage during the daytime and attempt to perform bin packing for online services and adjust nodes for offline services usage during the nighttime. The tidal co-location solution has two primary application scenarios. One is elastic training. In scenarios like computer vision or natural language processing, it's common to fully load the required model parameters into a GPU's memory, and using the all reduce button can make more efficient use of bandwidth. Workers, as for the framework characteristics, workers support fault tolerance and elasticity. Elasticity leads to a significant increase in training speed, and it's positively correlated with the number of workers. In contrast, if the gun chair crashes, the training job will fail. Therefore, we allocate stable resources for the gun chair and the workers from zero to the minimum number of replicas to ensure the stability of the training job. In addition, we allocate elastic resources for the workers from the minimum to the maximum numbers of replicas to accelerate training. Another application scenario is tidal resource reuse. CTV or CTR models have extremely large number of parameters that cannot be stored on a single node, so the PS worker pattern is adopted. If the parameter server crashes, the training job will fail, and for workers, elasticity doesn't result in a significant increase in training speed. So we use tidal resource reuse instead of elastic training to enhance DNA resource utilization during the off-peak hours of online services. We lend the idle resources of online services to the workers of training jobs. That is to say, stable parameter servers and elastic workers collaborate to support training jobs. During the peak hours of online services, we stop idle parameter servers to release some resources so that online services can utilize more resources to alleviate degradation. In the third part, I will discuss the practical outcomes of these features. Through GPU sharing scheduling, we have boosted GPU utilization by more than 50%. Through topology-aware scheduling, we have increased communication bandwidth between training tasks by more than 2 times. Through tidal co-location, we have achieved a peak of tens of thousands of GPU cards reused. Finally, I will discuss future works and introduce the Catalyst community. Our core objective is to improve GPU utilization and enhance model training efficiency. To achieve these goals, we plan to support some new features and evolve the architecture. For example, we plan to enrich the scenarios for topology-aware scheduling and support regular GPU co-location. As for the architecture, we plan to integrate Catalyst with the dynamic resource allocation feature of Kubernetes. Here is the Catalyst community and my contact information. You can join the bi-weekly community meeting through this link and join the community log group through the QR code. Here, we welcome everyone to participate in community contributions. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me for discussion. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Please, if you have any questions, please contact Heisao via these QR codes. On top of this, at ByteDance Open Source, we also have a bunch of different open source projects, and you can join us on, on our Discord as well, if you'd like to learn more about KubeWorf, Catalyst, and some others, and also learn about our Innovators Program. Thank you all so much.